Hello, hello. How are you doing today? I really am doing well. My name is Anne Gladys Kishuhe, and I'm going to be taking you through a few quick tips for mompreneurs, for women in business, digital skills, and how they can help you to grow your business. So we're going to look at digital skills and how they can help you grow your business. It's going to be a pretty short and concise class, and I hope that it's going to be of great benefit to you and that it will help you to grow your business. We're going to be covering a few things. We're going to look at the introduction, why we are doing what we're doing. We're going to look at some of the goals that we have at Women in Digital Business, where I'm a lead trainer. We're going to look at examples of digital skills, benefits of digital skills, your part to play in this whole journey, as well as the conclusion. Now, Women in Digital Business is an initiative of Microsoft Philanthropies together with International Training Center and International Labor Organization. And for me, as the founder of Amazing Life Publishing House and Amazing Girl Mentorship Network, I am very keen on equipping people with information that can help them build their lives, and especially women, as seen in Amazing Girl Mentorship Network. Helping them to grow, to learn, to grow, and to become everything that they can possibly become by identifying their identity, worth, and purpose, and beginning to live it out. So, at Women in Digital Business, where I am now a lead trainer, we have a couple of goals. The first one is to provide you with basic skills and insights for digital entrepreneurship. We also want to help you to explore how digital tools can make your business more efficient, successful, and responsive to your consumers' needs. And finally, we want to help you make strategic decisions for the digital transformation of your business. Now, some examples of digital skills that we have marketing, we have graphic design, we have writing. Those are just a few examples. When you look at marketing, for example, you can use the marketing skills that you acquire to market yourself and your business, as well as market the services and businesses of another person or of another business, thus creating some income for yourself. When it comes to graphic design, another example of a digital skill, you can use that to make logos, flyers, magazines, presentations such as this one, and so much more. You can do that for your own business to market it or for other people's businesses, and then you earn from that. There's also writing as a digital skill, which you can use for SEO. We're going to be looking at SEO in future classes, copywriting, article writing, even books that you can eventually publish, inspire other people, and make money for yourself through that. So those are just a few examples of digital skills. There are so many more that we can talk about, and I'm sure you have many skills. As you watch this video, I would encourage you to comment, what digital skills do you have? And to let you know that whatever skills you have, you need to have marketing skills in order to attract clients and customers for yourself and for your business. Now, as we look at women in digital business, we are trying very hard to get women informed about how they can use the digital space to grow their businesses. You see, you have to do different things in order to get different results. If you keep on doing the same things you've been doing, you're going to keep on getting the same results that you've been getting, and that's not going to be good. So we need to focus on growth. And once we grow, we're able to do different things and then to get different results. So, what are some of the benefits of digital skills? I'm going to go over a few of them in summary, in brief, in a very short way. And if you have any questions about it, please feel free to ask the questions in the comments or to reach me through my email address, which I will share at the end of the video, and we can get to talking about this thing. So, the first benefit of digital skills, using digital skills for your business, is that you save time by speeding up your work. So you're able to do so much more with technology. For example, if you're trying to market your business, you can tell people one at a time what you do, or you can make a flyer that you share maybe on your WhatsApp status or on Facebook and reach so many people, and you don't have to use the same time and energy to reach those people. So technology helps you, digital skills help you to speed up your work and to save time. The other thing is that digital skills help you to produce higher quality work. Because if you were, for example, to prepare the information in front of you using pen and paper, it wouldn't come out as beautifully as it does look right now. So technology, digital skills help you to improve the quality of your work. When it comes to reaching clients, you're able to reach clients beyond your geographical space, beyond your neighborhood, beyond the people who live near you. You're able to reach even international clients. If you know how to set up, for example, adverts on a place like Facebook, you can target specific countries for the people that you want to reach. The other benefit of digital skills is automation and scheduling. I find this extremely helpful when I'm working on my Facebook work, for example. I prepare my content in advance and then I schedule it, I set it to go, so that whether or not I'm online, whether or not I'm with my phone or on the laptop, I'm still able to have my marketing and my information going out. I also use a lot of technology when it comes to scheduling messages for people to go out on certain dates because of different occasions. And that is also helpful in business. So another advantage of scheduling and automation is, for example, when you have WhatsApp business, you're able to set messages that people receive when they message you and you're not available on your phone. Or for every first-time customer who reaches out to you, you're able to set a message that you're going to see. Maybe they're going to book a meeting with you, maybe they're going to visit your website. That way, they see that you're still active and you're still responding to them, and they can still get helpful information when they come to you if any of you are not there in person. So we continue to look at some more benefits. You can easily explain what you do. So you can prepare a video, for example, tell people what you do, or a flyer for that matter, tell people what you do and simply share that flyer. That saves you a lot of time and you don't have to keep on the other benefit, repeating and duplicating that effort of explaining the same thing over and over again. The way digital skills help you to easily explain what you do is, for example, by use of graphics. When you tell people, for example, that you're a book publisher and you present an image of a book, then it's very, very clear what you're doing. When you tell people that you're selling certain toys, maybe for children or certain kitchen equipment, then it's very easy for people to understand what you're talking about. And when you share that nicely in a flyer or a video, then you don't have to keep on repeating yourself over and over again for every new customer. All you have to do is share that link or avail that information maybe on your WhatsApp catalog, and then people can always see what you have. All you have to do is share one link, and people will find all the information that they need to find about what you're doing. Then another benefit of digital skills is that you can reach many people at once. A simple example is this class that I am pre-recording because we agreed to do that in the WhatsApp group. So I'm going to pre-record this class and then I'm going to share it with the students in my group. And that way they're going to all have the class and I will be able to have reached all of those people at the same time instead of me speaking to every student at the time that is convenient for each one of them. The other thing with digital skills is that you can get passive income from these skills. This is especially so if you learn how to use marketing skills. That is one very, very important skill. If you learn how to use your marketing skills well, you can generate a lot of passive income. For example, through affiliate marketing, where you market products, and as soon as people read the information on that and purchase the products, then you make your money passively. You're not there explaining to them in person all the time. They simply watch your YouTube videos about the things that you're marketing, or they read your blog articles or whatever links that you have shared. And once they purchase, then you're able to make passive income. You're also able to make passive income through things such as publishing books, for example, on Amazon. You just share your flyers, you share your information, talk about your book, send people to Amazon, and whatever time of day and night it is in your country, people can still buy books from wherever they are in the world, and you will get your money passively through that. This is also true if you prepare courses, for example. Courses are very, very important. We can go into all these things in detail later on, but right now I just want to show you the potential that lies in having digital skills. The final digital skills I'm going to be looking at today, one, improved communication. Like I said earlier, when you talk about WhatsApp business and how you can have automated responses for your clients, then you're able to improve your communication. Clients get responses very, very quickly, and that works in their favor. You can also put up bots, robots, or chatbots, or AI bots on your website, where when people come and ask questions, they are able to find answers or to receive customized answers for the questions that they are asking. You can also have FAQs on your website, and that way customers can see answers to questions that they would like to ask, questions that other people have asked. And when you look at what people have been asking very many times, you can create responses for them, and that way you also save your time. You can also have improved products. I remember some time back, I was selling something called the Amazing Tile Cleaner, which is absolutely amazing. It helps you just make your tiles sparkle and shine all over again. And one of the benefits that I had because of using my digital skills was making very beautiful labels for them. They would be printed in high quality paper and in color, properly stuck. I mean, it was just wonderful. And then I was using a lot of technology for the sourcing of the products that I was creating, as well as the logistics and delivery of those products. I was also using my digital marketing skills to market the products, and I was able to sell the products across the country to many different places. So when you have that kind of packaging for your product, of course, it's going to be perceived in a better way than when you're marking your products using masking tape, you know, in a pen or a felt pen. So technology, these digital skills, graphic design, and the rest help you to improve your products. Again, we have improved processes that I have alluded to a bit earlier. So in some of the work that I do, for example, the publishing that I mentioned earlier, you can work with me online without ever meeting me. And I have clients who are now publishing their fourth books, their fifth books. We've never met. We only hold online meetings. We talk on phone, on email, and the work still goes on. And then we have all of the technology that, you know, we have on this end being used in the publishing processes. And then we have a logistics department that caters to the delivery of those books once they're printed. And you can also do the same as a woman entrepreneur, because you see, as a woman entrepreneur, you're very, very busy. You're probably busy with your children, you're cooking, you're taking care of the house. You have so many responsibilities on your shoulders. How can you leverage technology to work for you? And those are some of the things we're going to be talking about later. So if I have mentioned something so far that you would like me to cover in detail, please let me know in the comments and I will do exactly that. I will make a class specifically for that, and you'll be able to learn, as you know, everything that I know. I am so very happy to teach, and I will answer your questions. The final benefit of having digital skills is making data-driven decisions and taking data-driven actions, because you cannot make decisions from a dark place. You can't just walk into a room and decide, in this dark room, I think we need to paint this color or the other. You need to know what is already existing for you to be able to come up with something. You need to know what your customers need, what your clients need, what they're looking for, or even what they don't even know they need, but you know it would benefit them. An example that I would think about, especially for moms who are nursing, are the nursing nipples that come. They are made of silicone, and you just put that over your, you know, your nursing area. And even if the baby, you know, bites on you with her gum, it's not as painful as it usually is when the baby bites on you without any protection. So you can anticipate needs for people by looking, by doing research, looking at the people around you or the people you're targeting, and then you make products and come up with services that those people specifically need. One of the examples I would say for this particular class that we're having is that I ran a poll in the WhatsApp group, and we had a conversation. Do we want pre-recorded classes? Are we available for a live class, all of us together? What is better? And many people chose to have pre-recorded classes because of the different schedules that we have. So now by having this class, you can take this class on your mobile phone, on your computer, wherever you are, at whatever time is suitable for you. And that is an example of a data-driven solution. So what is your part to do now? As you can see, we're offering this together with Women in Digital Business, Microsoft, International Training Center, International Labor Organization, of course, together with Amazing Life Publishing House and Amazing Girl Mentorship Network. We would like you, I passionately would like you to go to the portal, sign up for the classes if you haven't done that, and then go through the modules, do the tasks in each module, upload and submit the tasks that are there, and then you will receive your certificate. Once you have received your certificate, you are able to teach other people on the same, use the skills for yourself, or employ the skills in somebody else's company and get paid for that. Either way, you get to benefit in terms of increasing your knowledge as well as increasing your income. That brings us to the end of our very brief class for today. Thank you for your time. Thank you for listening. Thank you in advance for the comments and messages that you're going to send so that I can address your questions. You can reach me, I'm Gladys Kishoheli, trainer with Women in Digital Business. You can reach me through my email address, gladyskishohe@gmail.com. And you can also reach us at our publishing house, amazinglifehouse.com. Thank you once again for your time. All the very, very best in your digital journey. Let's keep rocking it, mothers. Let's keep rocking it, women.